in the supply curve, when price increases from $2 to $4, quantity increases from 10 to 20. From $4 to $6, quantity increases from 20 to 30. The dot just moves along this curve. In econspeak, this movement is called change in quantity supplied. When price changes, we say there's a change in quantity supplied. Remember, there are other factors affecting supply as well. For instance, when price of eggs increases, producing cakes gets more expensive. We'll bake fewer cakes at every price. At $2, at $4, at $6, at every price. So, the entire supply curve shifts to the left. In econspeak, we say this is a decrease in supply. What if price of eggs decreases? The cost of baking cakes decreases. Profits increase, so bake more cakes. Supply increases, so the supply curve shifts right. Let's add graphs into the summary. When price increases, quantity supply increases. It's a movement up the supply curve. When price decreases, quantity supplied decreases. It's a movement down the supply curve. When any of these non-price factors change in respective directions, supply increases. So the supply curve shifts right. When these factors change the other way, supply decreases. So supply curve shifts left. So far, we have been talking about individual supply. How do we derive the market supply? In other words, how many cakes can the market supply? If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe. Next up, market supply.